Hi, and welcome to Tiger Art. Today we'll be reading the story Where the Wild Things Are by Maurice Sendak. This is one of my favorite books from when I was a kid because it's a story of great imagination. And it's also about monsters. Monsters are cool because they come from our imagination. And that means that they really could be anything. And for an artist, that's a pretty cool way to think. We can make things anything we want them to be. Let's read the story Where the Wild Things Are. The night Max wore his wolf suit and made mischief of one kind and another. His mother called him Wild Thing, and Max said, "I'll eat you up." So he was sent to bed without eating anything. That very night in Max's room, a forest grew. And grew. And grew until his ceiling hung with vines and the walls became the world all around. And an ocean tumbled by with a private boat for Max. And he sailed off through night and day. And in and out of weeks, and almost over a year, to where the wild things are. And when he came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars, and gnashed their terrible teeth, and rolled their terrible eyes, and showed their terrible claws, until Max said, "Be still," and tamed them with the magic trick of staring into all their yellow eyes without blinking once. And they were frightened and called him the most wild thing of all and made him king of all wild things. "And now," cried Max, "let the wild rumpus start." "Stop," said Max, and sent the wild things off to bed without their supper. And Max, king of all wild things, was lonely, and he wanted to be where someone loved him best of all. Then, all around, from far away across the world, he smelled good things to eat. So he gave up being king of where the wild things are. But the wild things cried, "Oh, please don't go. We'll eat you up. We love you so." And Max said, "No." The wild things roared their terrible roars and gnashed their terrible teeth and rolled their terrible eyes and showed their terrible claws. But Max stepped into his private boat and waved goodbye and sailed back over a year and in and out of weeks and through a day and into the night of his very own room, where he found his supper waiting for him. And it was still hot. So Max has this imaginary world where these wild things live. And the wild things are like monsters, so they're imaginary. What are some things that a monster could have? A monster could have really sharp teeth, could have really sharp claws, could have really big feet, could have really big hands. It could have tentacles like an octopus or a squid, could have wings or fins. Or flippers. How many eyes does a monster have? Could have as many as you want. Could have as few as you want. Could have none. How many arms does a monster have? How many legs? How many toes? As many as you want. Could have two heads. Could have three heads. Could have more than that. Could have fur. Could have scales. could have a bunch of little feet. Could be long and skinny, could be short, could be tall. Could be anything you want it to be. So when making a monster, remember that. Don't make it look like a person. Don't make it have two arms and two legs unless you want to change something else about it. But it could really be as strange as you want it to be. Okay, so today we're going to be drawing a monster, and I thought it would be cool to try doing this in Seesaw on your iPad. So when you get out of this video, you'll go to Seesaw, and you'll find in your activities, you'll find our activity for today. When you go to add a response to this, it will bring up this template for you. So you'll be able to work right on here. This is a drawing board, and I've already turned it black for you, which would be great for drawing monsters. Over here on the right, you have a slider that can change the color. So if you want to draw with yellow, move that slider up to yellow. And then anything you draw on here will show up as yellow. The coolest thing about digital drawing is that you can undo and redo. Up at the top of your screen, there's an arrow that is curved and points to the left. That's your undo button. If you click that, it will undo whatever you just did. I would strongly encourage you to use that button to go backwards. So if you make a mistake or something you don't like, use the undo button. If you want it back, the button right next to it is the redo button, and it will bring it back. Down at the bottom of your screen are your drawing tools. Using the pencil isn't really going to help us very much for this assignment. Using the pen here is going to be much better for us. If you tap the pen again, it gives you different sizes. So you can make it a big pen, or you can make it a very small pen. For the beginning, I want you to stick with the small pen. I'm going to hit undo to get rid of that. So we're going to be drawing some monsters. Let's create a monster from our imagination. So you're going to make your monster. Make it colorful. Use lots of different colors. Be creative. Have fun with this. And when you're finished with it, all you have to do is hit the green check mark.